Research in the Pacific Northwest National Laboratory Glass Lab is aimed at improving the Hanford cleanup mission. The work will expand the range of waste to be treated and reduce the overall mission life for the Hanford Tank Waste Treatment and Immobilization Plant. WTP's mission is to vitrify millions of gallons of tank waste produced at Hanford during past defense production activities. Waste was stored in 177 waste tanks, each containing different mixtures of chemicals and radionuclides. The waste will be immobilized in glass logs to be safely stored for hundreds of thousands of years. As WTP transitions from startup to full operations, researchers at PNNL are developing advanced process control models that will reduce uncertainties, increase waste loading, and improve waste processing efficiency compared to the baseline process. PNNL invented the joule-heated, liquid-fed ceramic melter in the 1970s. This is the baseline technology for nuclear waste vitrification, not only at WTP, but at other nuclear sites around the globe, including Germany, Belgium, Japan, China, and India. The melter uses heat up to 1,150 degrees Celsius, or 2,100 degrees Fahrenheit, to convert a mixture of waste and glass-forming chemicals to a molten glass, which is then poured into stainless steel canisters. Once the glass is cooled and solidified, there's no reworking it. And with constantly varying waste streams, deciding what types and amounts of glass-forming chemicals to add, that is, the glass recipe, relies on sophisticated models. The models were developed and verified at PNNL using experimental data. Measurements were taken from both radioactive and non-radioactive glasses produced in the lab and in melters in the radiochemical processing laboratory with real tank waste. The resulting models are agile and robust to rapidly assess the variable waste streams entering the melter and balance waste feed composition against a long list of processing constraints and factors that affect durability of the glass. Simultaneously, the models create recipes that optimize waste loading without negatively impacting processing rates. The models have been incorporated into advanced process control software, and PNNL is continuing to develop additional models focused on future waste streams. Our systematic experimental approach evaluates component changes to determine the impact of varying glass properties over the broader glass compositional region to allow a wider range of operating parameters at WTP. This reduces the need for chemical adjustments to pre-treat the waste prior to vitrification. Glass recipes developed using the models have shown significant increases in waste loading for key waste streams or troublesome components like chromium, sulfur, and aluminum. For instance, the maximum aluminum fraction in glass has increased from 13% in the baseline case to over 30% for the advanced glasses without any deleterious effects on the quality of the glass or processing rate. The Department of Energy's Office of River Protection supports the Enhanced Waste Glass Program at PNNL for continuous improvement in vitrification of the tank waste. Advancements in glass science offer higher waste loadings and increased processing rates. This could significantly reduce the amount of glass produced and potentially the time required to process all wastes. These science advancements, along with the ability to accept a wider range of waste constituents for operational flexibility, offers a clear return on investment.